plaque here at St Mary's Primary School, just off Dorset Street, was unveiled during the school's International Day, which celebrates the rich cultural diversity among the pupils here. Now, this is an area from which many members of the Citizen Army hailed, including the author of the organisation's constitution and the foremost chronicler of Dublin tenement life, the playwright Sean O'Casey. Born here at 85 Dorset Street in March 1880, Sean O'Casey's family were Protestant, and their background has been described by one biographer as shabby genteel. Now, with the death of his father, the young O'Casey and his many siblings knew great hardship, and they were forced to move many times across the north inner city. Born John Casey, he was greatly affected by the Celtic cultural revival and reinvented himself, firstly as Sean O'Cahasic and later as Sean O'Casey. As a young man, he joined both the Irish Republican Brotherhood and the Irish Transport and General Workers Union, but by 1914, he was growing increasingly hostile to nationalism. O'Casey became Secretary of the Irish Citizen Army and drafted the organisation's constitution in March 1914. It was resolutely internationalist, but also anti-sectarian, stating that one of the objectives of the new organisation shall be to sink all difference of birth, property and creed under the name of the common Irish people. O'Casey's animosity towards the Irish volunteers was strong, and he believed that there were fundamental class tensions between the two organisations. He challenged Countess Markovitch over her dual membership of both bodies, and when a motion he put forward calling on her to renounce one or the other failed, O'Casey left the Citizen Army behind him. O'Casey was highly critical of the decision of the Citizen Army to align with the volunteers at Easter in 1916, but despite that, he became the first chronicler of the organisation, writing A History of the Citizen Army in 1919 and The Plough and the Stars in 1926, which debuted here at the Abbey Theatre. Sean O'Casey died in England in 1964, a committed communist until his dying day. But like many revolutionaries, he was deeply disillusioned with the conservative Catholic state which emerged here following the revolution.